Being prepared for an emergency is not something many people think about, but if the unfortunate occurs, you are involved in an earthquake, hurricane, or worse, you'll thank yourself for being ready with just three things required for you and your loved ones to survive and thrive in a catastrophe: water, food, and sleep. In a pinch, the human body can survive for several days, even weeks, without access to food. And although you might have a partner that snores, you should be able to find a place to sleep in an emergency. But without water, the human body can only survive around 80 hours. That's just 3 days. Today, I'm going to show you how, with a few simple steps, you can strain, decontaminate, and purify surface groundwater even in an emergency. To do this, we are going to need a clean cotton t-shirt or cloth, some household full concentration chlorine bleach, a bucket with a lid, and a Santevia countertop unit. Let's take a look at how we're going to disinfect this water. So I found an irrigation ditch. Let's go down and see if we can collect about 2 US gallons of water. So you see the quality of the water that we collect is obviously very dirty, and if you were to drink that, you would most definitely get sick. Let's go see if we can turn this into potable drinking water. The first thing that we're going to do is to take a sample of the water that we're going to send off to a lab just to see what actually was in the water. The first thing that we're going to do to disinfect this water is called aeration. Aeration brings water into close contact with air, which increases the oxygen content of the water. Once you're finished shaking the water for 5 minutes, you're gonna let it stand for 30 minutes or longer. After we've aerated the water, the next thing that we're going to do is strain it through a clean tea towel. Pouring water through a clean piece of cloth will remove some of the suspended silt and solids. It's important that a clean cloth is used, as a dirty cloth may introduce some additional contaminants into the water. Now that we've finished straining the water and it's back into our main container, we're going to move on with chemical disinfection. Many chemicals can disinfect water, but the most commonly used is chlorine. Today, we'll use liquid chlorine bleach, and we'll add about 1.5 milliliters of bleach to each gallon of water. So here we have 3 gallons of water, so we'll use 4.5 milliliters of chlorine bleach. Place the lid back on, seal the container, and mix it very well. And once you've mixed it, you can leave it for about 30 minutes to 1 hour. Now that the chlorine has been in the container for about 30 minutes to 1 hour, we're going to place it into the countertop. The countertop contains a ceramic pre-filter, which is designed to filter bacteria and parasites that may not have been eliminated by the chlorine. Water will then pass through the fluoride filter, reducing the amount of chlorine in the water, herbicides, pharmaceuticals, fluoride, industrial chemicals, trihalomethanes, heavy metals, organic chemicals, particulates, odors, and tastes. Now that we've waited some time, the water has flowed from the top or the upper tank of the countertop unit down to the base. You'll see the water, the top here is quite yellow, and also the ceramic pre-filter is very, very yellow or orange. It's been taking a lot of particles out of the water. The base of the countertop looks quite clear, very drinkable. I'm going to take 2 samples, one a taste test that I'll smell, and then also a sample for the lab that we'll send off and do a microbiological test. So first I'll take the sample for the lab. Now you'll remember that we also took a sample at the beginning of this video, and we'll send them both off so that we can take a sample essentially of the influent and effluent and see the difference, basically what was in the water before we filtered it and what was in the water after we filtered it. So the water looks very clear. It doesn't have any smell. And it actually tastes pretty good. To filter this ditch water, we followed the recommendations provided by the World Health Organization and the American Center for Disease Control. And although the water looked very clean when we filtered it, we wanted to be certain by sending samples to a local lab. We tested for two things. We tested E. coli and fecal coliform bacteria. The lowest detection limit of the lab was 1 MPN per 100 milliliters. The untreated water that we collected from the ditch tested at 920 for E. coli and 602 for fecal coliform bacteria. The Canadian Drinking Water Quality Guideline says that there should be no fecal coliform or E. coli detected. After performing filtration, the final test showed that there was no detectable E. coli or coliform bacteria present in the water. Or in other words, this water would have been safe to drink in an emergency. We sourced water from an irrigation ditch as an exaggerated way to show how effective using these filtration techniques can be. However, sourcing water from a river, swimming pool, or other cleaner water source is advisable to prevent illness.